Hello friends, this is Subodh. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Psychotech. In this video, I will discuss about BDI, that is Back Depression Inventory, which is the widely used instrument in research because it represented a shift in healthcare professionals' view of depression from a Freudian psychodynamic perspective to one guided by the patient's own thought or cognitions. So friends, if you are new to this channel and you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Using BDI, we can assess sadness, pessimism, past failure, loss of pleasure, guilty feelings, punishment feelings, self-dislike, self-criticalness, suicidal thoughts of risk, crying, agitation, loss of interest, indecisiveness, worthlessness, loss of energy, change in sleep pattern, irritability, changes in appetite, concentration difficulty, tiredness or fatigue, loss of interest in sex. So BDI consists these 21 items which we can assess using this questionnaire. So let's start the video. So if we talk about the BDI, so BDI, that is the Back Depression Inventory, created by Aaron T. Beck, is a 21 question multiple choice self report inventory, one of the most widely used psychometric tests for measuring the severity of depression. So it is mostly used for measuring the severity of depression. There are three versions of BDI. The original was called as BDI, first published in 1961 and later revised in 1978 as the BDI 1A and the BDI 2, published in 1996. The BDI is widely used as an assessment tool by healthcare professionals and researchers in a variety of settings. If we talk about the consistency, so consistency for the BDI ranges from 0.73 to 0.92 with a mean of 0.86. The BDI demonstrates high internal consistency with alpha coefficients of 0.86 and 0.81 for psychiatric and non-psychiatric population respectively. Now I will discuss about the first version of BDI questionnaire. The original BDI, first published in 1961, consisted of 21 questions about how the subject has been feeling in the last week, and each question had a set of at least 4 possible responses ranging in intensity. For example, 0 to 3, at 0 I don't feel sad, 1 I feel sad, 2 I am sad all the time and I can't snap off it, 3 I am so sad or unhappy that I can't stand it. When the test is scored, a value of 0 to 3 is assigned for each answer, and then the total score is compared to determine the depression severity. In BDI, the standard cutoff scores were as follows: 0 to 9 indicates minimal depression, 10 to 18 indicates mild depression, 19 to 29 indicates moderate depression, 30 to 63 indicates severe depression. Higher total scores indicate more severe depression symptoms. Some items on the original BDI had more than one statement marked with the same score. For instance, there are 2 responses under the mood heading that score are 2. 2A4, I am blue or sad all the time and I can't snap out of it, and 2B4, I am so sad or unhappy that it is very painful. Now if we look at the next version of BDI, that is BDI 1A. So the BDI 1A was a revision of the original instrument developed by Beck during the 1970s and copyrighted in 1978. To improve ease of use, the A and B statements were removed and respondents were instructed to endorse how they had been feeling during the preceding 2 weeks. The internal consistency for the BDI 1A was good, with a Kornback alpha coefficient of around 0.85, meaning that the items on the inventory are highly correlated with each other. However, this version retained some flaws. The BDI 1A only addressed 6 out of the 9 DSM-3 criteria for depression. This and other criticisms were addressed in next version of BDI, that is BDI-2. So in BDI-2, the BDI-2 was a 1996 revision of the BDI developed in response to the American Psychiatric Association's publication of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, 4th edition, which changed many of the diagnostic criteria for major depressive disorder. Items involving changes in body image, hypochondriasis, and difficulty working were replaced. Also, sleep loss and appetite loss items were revised to assess both increases and decreases in sleep and appetite. All but three of the items were rewarded. Only the items dealing with feelings of being punished, thought about suicide, and interest in sex remained the same. Like the BDI 2 also contained 21 questions, each answer being scored on a scale value of 0 to 3. Higher total score indicate more severe depressive symptoms. Participants are asked to rate how they have been feeling for the past 2 weeks as opposed to the past week as in the original BDI. The BDI 2 is designed for individuals of age 13 and over and is composed of items relating to symptoms of depression such as hopelessness and irritability, cognitions such as guilt or feeling of being punished, as well as physical symptoms such as fatigue, weight loss, and lack of interest in sex. The BDI-2 is positively correlated with the Hamilton Depression Rating Scale with a Pearson correlation of 0.71, showing good agreement. The test was also shown to have a high 1 week test retest reliability measured by Pearson correlation, which was 0.93, suggesting that it was only overly sensitive to daily variations in mood. The test also has high internal consistency, that is alpha equal to 0.91. So if we talk about the impact of back depression inventory, the development of BDI was an important event in psychiatry as well as in psychology. It represented a shift in healthcare professionals' view of depression from a Freudian psychodynamic perspective to one guided by the patient's own thought or cognitions. It also established the principle that instead of attempting to develop a psychometric tool based on possibly invalid theory, self-report questionnaires, when analyzed using techniques such as factor analysis, can suggest theoretical constructs. The BDI was originally developed to provide a quantitative assessment of the intensity of depression. Because it is designed to reflect the depth of depression, it can monitor changes over time and provide an objective measure for judging improvement and effectiveness or otherwise of treatment methods. The instrument in BDI remains widely used in research. In 1998, it had been used in over 2000 empirical studies. It has been translated into multiple European languages as well as Arabic, Chinese, Japanese, Persian, and Xhosa. As other tests, the BDI has also some limitations. And if you look at the limitations of BDI, the BDI suffers from the same problem as other self-report inventories, in that scores can be easily exaggerated or minimized by the person completing them. Like all the questionnaires, the way the instrument is administered can have an effect on the final score. If a patient is asked to fill out the form in front of other people in a clinical environment, for instance, social expectations have been shown to elicit a different response compared to administration via postal survey. In participants with concomitant physical illness, the BDI's reliance on physical symptoms such as fatigue may artificially inflate the score due to symptoms of the illness rather than of depression. In an effort to deal with this concern, Beck and his colleagues developed the Beck Depression Inventory for Primary Care, BDI-PC, which is a short screening scale consisting of 7 items from BDI-2 and considered to be independent of physical function. Unlike the standard BDI, BDI-PC produces only a binary outcome of not depressed or depressed for the patients above a cutoff score of 4. Although designed as a screening device rather than a diagnostic tool, the BDI is sometimes used by healthcare providers to reach a quick diagnosis. The BDI is copyrighted. A fee must be paid for each copy used. There is no evidence that the BDI-2 is more valid or reliable than other depression scales. And public domain scales such as patient health questionnaires, 9-item, PHQ-9, have been studied as a useful tool. Now, if you look at the availability and clinical use, so the BDI-2 is copyrighted. The rights are held by Harcourt Assessment and Cooperation, Pearson Education, PLC, under contract from the author. A fee is required for the manual and record forms. This limits availability. In occupational health, the BDI-2 can be used as a screening tool to detect depression in normal populations or as a tool to assess symptom severity in clinical populations. Before administering the test on subject, an instruction must be given to the subject. An instruction should be like, this questionnaire consists of 21 groups of statements. Please read each group of statement carefully and then pick out the one statement in each group that best describes the way you have been feeling during the past 2 weeks, including today. Circle the number beside the statement you have picked. If several statements in the group seem to apply equally well, circle the highest number for that group. Be sure that you do not choose more than one statement for any group, including item 16, which is for changes in sleeping pattern, or item 18, which is for changes in appetite. This BDI test assess the severity of depression on the basis of 21 items. From 1 to 21, there are 21 questions in the test, and the first question is related to sadness, second is for pessimism, third is for past failure, likewise loss of pleasure, guilty feelings, punishment feelings, self-dislike, self-criticalness, suicidal thoughts or wishes, crying, agitation, loss of interest, indecisiveness, worthlessness, loss of energy, changes in sleep pattern, irritability, changes in appetite, concentration difficulty, tiredness or fatigue, and last question for loss of interest in sex. So after administering this BDI test on some subject, let us look at the interpretation part. So how to interpret the BDI? After you have completed the questionnaire, add up the scores for each of the 21 questions by counting the number to right of the each question you marked. The highest possible total for the whole test would be 63. This would mean you circle number 3 on all 21 questions. Since the lowest possible score for each question is 0, the lowest possible score for test would be 0. This would mean you circle 0 on each question. You have to give special attention to the correct scoring of the changes in sleeping pattern, which is item 16, and changes in appetite, which is item 18. Each of these items contains 7 options rated in order 0, 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B. These are 7 options to differentiate between increases and decreases in behavior or motivation. If a higher rated option is chosen by the respondent, the presence of an increase or decrease in either symptoms should be clinically noted for diagnostic purposes. Now you can evaluate the level of depression according to the table you can see here. If total score is between 1 to 10, including 1 and 10, these ups and downs are considered normal. 11 to 16, mild mood disturbance. 17 to 20, borderline clinical depression. 21 to 30, moderate depression. 31 to 40, severe depression. And over 40, it means extreme depression. So using this table, you can interpret the result of the test conducted on any subject. And accordingly, you can write the report. So this was all about BDI, BDI 1A and BDI 2. If you have any question, you can write in the comment section. And for more psychological tests and psychology related concepts, you can subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.